cardio golf video is more of a tutorial to help you understand how the human body moves in the golf swing. You see, it's really important to understand how your body moves, how all your muscles and joints need to go through entire full ranges of motion in different planes of motion in order to be effective. You see, your muscles need to work in all the different planes of motion, in the sagittal plane, in the frontal plane, in the transverse plane. So it's important to understand how that works. So I'll be showing you how your muscles and joints work. And when you have that understanding, it will be easier for you to build your golf fitness program to meet your needs. So this is a video tutorial, but it's also a routine that you can do on a daily basis to help keep mobility going in all your joints and muscles. So all you need is your shorty practice training club for this. All right, so let's go ahead and start with one of the first movements that's important for the golf swing, and that's shoulder flexion. Shoulder flexion is simply the shoulder's ability to raise the arms up and down right here. So this would be called shoulder flexion. So this would be a great exercise just to help you get those shoulders moving. So stand a nice athletic stance, roll your shoulders away from your ears. Just hold your shorty club right here. And from here, you're keeping your torso very stable and you're just raising your arms. The next movement in the shoulder would be the opposite of flexion, which is actually extension, taking your shoulder behind you to lift your arms up behind you. So really good exercise would just be to hold the shorty club behind your back like this, and then again stand in a nice wide athletic stance, and then just lift and lower, squeezing your shoulder blades together. This is shoulder extension. So this is a great exercise. So this might be more difficult than the flexion, but this is a really great exercise to open up that chest and back to learn how to take. All right, let's move down to the hips. The hips need to be able to also flex and extend. So you need to have some flexion and extension in those hips, and that's really important in the golf swing because, of course, your setup involves that flexion of the hips loading into that side, and then on the follow through, it involves the extension of the hips being able to thrust your hips forward in order. Again, just like the shoulder has flexion and extension, the hips have flexion and then extension. So this is a really good exercise to do. Just hold your shorty club like this, stand in a nice athletic posture. Make sure your chin is in line with your spine so you don't want your chin looking up like this. And then you're just pressing your hips forward, trying to get into a little bit. If you have any tightness in those hips and you can't do that extension, what happens is instead of lowering and starting your swing with your lower body first, the tendency will be to start with your upper body instead. So lots of compensations, probably a big slice over the top, loss of power. So you want to make sure that you can extend those hips in order to create power in the golf swing. Let's move back up to the elbows. So it's really important to make sure that your elbows can flex and extend as well. So you can see the front arm extends, and then as you shift your weight and rotate your forearms, then that front arm flexes and the back arm extends through. And that's how you get power in your golf swing, by rotating those forearms, squaring the club face. If you have any issues with this flexion right here, or extension, then you're gonna cause swing. All right, moving back down to the knees also have flexion and extension like that. So this is a really good exercise to just practice flexing. You can get that hamstring right there and your quad, and then that extension right there. And if you do it on one leg like this, it's a really great balance exercise. Full extension. Like this. And if you can do it with balance, that's even better. If you have to, hold on to something. So that's really important in the golf swing. Obviously, you need to have some knee flexion at the start of your swing and throughout the backswing. And then you want to have some knee extension, being able to push off and extend those knees so that you can use the ground as power to get your sequencing correct. So make sure that if you have any issues with that extension and that flexion, and the terms for that is actually dorsiflexion. When you flex, you pull your toes towards your shin, and plantar flexion, when you point your toes down. So you need to be able to do that with your ankles That's really good. And a lot of us have some mobility issues with those ankles. So just doing this exercise right here where you just set up and with one leg forward, sit a little bit into your hips, and then practice doing that flexion, dorsiflexion, and then planting your foot. And you'll feel this in the front of your leg and your ankle. So you want to be able to take those ankles through full range. So do 5 or 6 on one, and then do 5 or 6 on the other. So this would be a great way to warm up those ankles before you play or practice. And that's important in the golf swing. I see a lot of people have ankle issues, so they're unable to keep their weight on the insides of their feet. They'll lift up. So that term is abduction and adduction. Being able to take your hip out to the side is abduction. Being able to drag it back in is adduction. So this movement is really important in the golf swing, taking your leg out to the side and coming across like this. So going out like this is a really great exercise, and coming back in and swinging your leg across is a great exercise. So if you have to hold on to something. So if you're doing these exercises with me, you should start to feel something in those joints, in those muscles, and those are the things that you're using during the golf swing. So those are the things that you want to make sure you work out. So when you're building a golf fitness program, you want to address the ones where you have weaknesses and build those up to make sure that they're your strengths. Moving down to the ankles, your ankles need to move in a certain way in order to help support your body, plus also help you shift your weight. So they have to be mobile in order to be able to shift the weight on the backswing and then accept that weight on the follow through. So you have to have some mobility in those ankles. You have to be able to do eversion, which is your ankles moving inward, and inversion, which is your ankles moving to the outside, the weight moving to the outside. So the motion that happens between your upper and lower body is very important. You need to be able to separate what the upper body is doing from the lower body. And this is in the transverse plane. You need to be able to rotate your upper body on the backswing and then the lower body on the downswing. So you have to have that separation. Where a lot of people go wrong is because they lack some mobility in this area. So a good exercise would be to just put a club across your shoulders like this. Keep your upper body very stable and just practice turning your hips independently from your upper body like this. You can also do the reverse by keeping your hips very still and then trying to move your upper body independently. So let's talk about what happens to our forearms. So in the golf swing, your forearms need to be able to rotate, which includes what happens with your wrist and your elbows. You need to be able to rotate your forearms, your wrist, your elbows on the backswing, and then re-rotate them back to impact, to square the club face. You need to be able to supinate and pronate your forearm, your wrist, your elbows. So they have to be able to do this action here. If there's any discrepancy. So a good exercise to help you improve that pronation, supination would be to just hold a golf club like this, and then it has a little bit of weight, and then you would just practice rotating your forearms like this, learning how to supinate one forearm and pronate the other one. And then going back to our shoulders, you need to be able to externally and internally rotate your shoulders. So if you have any discrepancies in this area or any impingement, or if this hurts, it's going to be hard for you to. So you need to be able to take those shoulders through full range. So doing exercises that help that internal, external rotation will really help you in your golf swing. There are lots of different exercises to help you with that internal, external shoulder rotation, where you can hold on to a weight or a band and you practice rotating like this. This is the external rotation, this is the internal rotation, and you would do that with both arms, trying to make sure that rotates. Another motion that happens in the hips is that internal and external hip rotation. You need to be able to rotate those hips internally, externally. That's going to help you wind up in the backswing. That's going to help you unwind and use your lower body on the downswing. If you have any discrepancies in that rotation in your hips, you'll end up coming over the top or making some sort of swing compensation. So there you have it, all the different actions and planes of motions that happen within your joints and your muscles that help you create a good golf swing. It's important to have an understanding of those different movements. You want to make sure that you pinpoint the movements that you have some discrepancies with and address those first. Get those back into balance. Once you're all balanced and you can take your muscles through their full range of motion, then you can go ahead and work on increasing power and clubhead speed.